TJ, I'm taking your f***ing stack up.
Dude, when I count my chips, it gets all f***ed up. I don't want to know if I can.
Everyone, good luck.
It's Sunday. You know what that means. It's another week of the Vineland Poker League, and I'm ready to final table, record a good finish, and rise in the standings. I'm currently in 16th out of 40 after last week's 36-point score, which is fine because it's still very early in the year. Today we have an interesting table. I'll be playing with tight players like Matt G, Matt W, and Spider, wild cards like Mark and Josh, Nick M, who's new this year, Rob, who won in 2021, Kenny, who sent a sub this week, and Jesse, who's currently in first place. Are you ready? Let's get in to Vineland Poker League Week 3.
Texas Dolly Brunson, who wrote the book.
Moving in for the kill.
And there it is. Helmuth wins the championship.
Moneymaker puts his name amongst the greatest players in the game.
Wake me now.
Greg Merson is the main event champion.
It's gonna be the best day of my life.
Biggest day of my life.
There's a lot of subs today, which will either make this week much tougher or much easier. Let's get into the action.
A little longer than a few minutes later.
And the beginning of the tournament didn't quite go as planned. 30 minutes in, I have 29,925 chips and haven't really played a hand. I'm only still around 30k because I popped it up to 525 at 100-200 with a king-queen and Josh called. We checked it all the way down and my king-high beat his queen-high. Hopefully, I'll be able to show you some playable hands today. With blinds at 150-300, I've found somewhat of a playable hand. It folds to Josh in late position, who min-raises to 600. Nick calls in the cutoff, Mark calls on the button, and I toss in an extra 300 chips in the middle with king-9 off, ending the action and bringing us four ways to a flop. The flop comes 6-jack-8 with two clubs, and I check. Josh doesn't c-bet, and Nick and Mark check as well. The turn is the jack of spades pairing the board, and I check again. This time, Josh bets 1,200. Nick folds, and Mark folds also. Does Josh have the goods here? He was the preflop raiser, but maybe only because it folded to him in late position, and he did check the flop. Was it a sneaky check on the flop? Or is he turning his preflop raised hand into a bluff because he thinks it'll get through after the board paired? Should I let my hand go?
Let it go, let it go.
I decide to fold after considering all my options. Nice bet, Josh, especially if I was good with King High. With blinds at 200-400, I pick up Queen-Jack offsuit on the button. It folds to Matt G in the cutoff, who limps. I limp, Jesse completes in the small blind, and Spider makes it 1,500 in the big blind. Matt calls, and I decide to preserve my chips and muck my hand. What would you have done here? Jesse folds as well, and I deal the Queen-3-9 flop to Spider and Matt G. Spider bets 2k, and Matt G calls pretty quickly. Unfortunately, I deal another queen on the turn. Spider bets out again and Matt folds. I asked Spider what he had and he didn't tell me. Maybe I dodged a bullet there? I mean, look at these hands that I'm getting dealt. The borderline ones that I play, I lose, and the bad ones I fold and lose too. Not a good way to win tournaments. We gotta turn something around here. With blinds at 200-400, I'm in the big blind with Queen-7 offsuit, the hand before the first break. Greg in early position limps, and it folds around to Mark on the button, who min raises to 800. I'm not letting my hand go that easily, and I'm looking to get lucky here. Greg completes as well, and we go three ways to the two of spades, jack of spades, ace of hearts flop. I check, Greg checks too, and Mark bets 1,800. I figure Mark has an ace here, or at least a made hand if he raised pre and c-bet on the flop. That would make it pretty hard for me to bluff here and try to take down a pot that's probably not mine. Thinking this, I get out of the way and go to break.
Well, not much has happened so far. It's probably one of the most boring starts to a tournament I've had in a while. Got 28k, really haven't played a hand. What's the deal, boys and girls?
Smidge over starting.
You don't have 90 this week?
Not yet.
Nick, you still in?
Yeah, this week I am.
Let's go. Cardo, what's up? He's subbing for Tim, right?
Yep.
Came out to play with the boys today. We resumed in a few minutes, so let's get it.
The second hand after the break, I pick up one of the prettiest hands I've seen so far today on the button. Ace 4 of spades. Nick calls the 500 in middle position. Matt G makes it 1,500 in the cutoff. This is a tough decision for me. I tip my hat to Matt G here. He sits here all day and usually plays a couple hands, sometimes one hand an hour. I think I call here if anyone else made this raise, but nice raise, Matt. Easy fold. Okay, so I'm virtually ding-dongless so far in the tournament, and I'm eager to hand out my first dong. I pick up king-queen of spades in late position at 250-500 blinds, and when it folds to me after Mark limps under the gun plus one, I make it 20-50. It folds to Josh, who thinks it over, but eventually folds. And then it's up to Matt W., who folds after saying I better have a big hand. And Mark the limper gets out of the way too. I show my cards, even though Matt says he knows he's going to see it anyway on the vlog. And finally, we can dong him. With blinds still at 250-500, I'm in the big blind with ace-10 of spades. Greg raises to 1200 in early position and says, quote, I want to get in a pot with TJ. Nick calls in the cutoff, Mark folds his button, and Matt G folds his small blind. I complete, ending the action and bringing us to a three-handed flop. The flop comes 7-4-5 with two clubs, which wasn't exactly what I was looking for. So I check. Greg c-bets for 2,000, and Nick shoves it in for 10,050. Two pink chips and two green chips. I can't do much here besides fold, and Greg snap calls. Nick turns over pocket jacks, and Greg turns over 7-8 offsuit. Interesting that you raised it up in early position with that hand, Greg. But that questionable raise works out for him when Mark deals the 6 of diamonds on the turn, giving Greg the check mark and sending Nick to the rail in 39th place. With blinds at 300-600, it folds to me on the button and I make it 1200 with King Jack of Hearts. Jesse in the small blind and Spider in the big blind both make the call. The somewhat favorable flop comes Queen 10-8 rainbow and we check around. The Deuce of Spades hits the turn and Jesse casually announces, he called my small preflop raise and checked the flop and led the turn after we all checked the flop? I think with my open ender, I need to fight back here. I make it 5,200, and in less than 20 seconds, Jesse re-raises to 15,000. Wow. Is Jesse bluffing here? Does he have a set of some kind? He's putting me in a very tough spot, and this is a man that's new to the league this year, so out of all my table mates, I've definitely played less hands with him than anyone else here. Maybe this is why Jesse is currently in first place in the league. Super tough spot. I take the safe route, lay it down, and he shows me pocket queens for top set. Must be nice to be first in the league and just be out here flopping top set. A few hands later, I limp with a couple of face cards when it folds to me. Jesse calls, Spider calls, Rob calls, Matt folds his small blind, and interestingly enough, Mark just mucks his big blind.
Damn, Mark, you just muck out your big blind?
So we go four ways to a flop, which comes 7-9-10 with two diamonds. I check, and Jesse bets 1,000. Spider and Rob both fold, and it's time for a rematch against Jesse. I'm not letting him get a chance to improve easily, so I put in a raise to 2275. He mucks bottom pair, and we take down a small pot. It doesn't seem that small, though. I'll take every chip I can get right now. It's going to be a big challenge to win this tournament, but I'm here for it.
Gambling is our lifeblood. You'll see it everywhere you look. You'll get challenged sooner or later, so I hope you'll be...
I'll get challenged, huh? Well, that sounds like something to look forward to.
With blinds at 400-800, it folds to me and I make it 2200 in late position with king-queen of clubs. I'm getting short, so it's time to make a move. My week 3 nemesis, Jesse, calls of course, and everyone else elects to watch this fight from the sidelines. The flop comes 8-6-9 rainbow and I check. Jesse throws in a bet of 3k, and guess what? I'm calling here. This guy can't have it every time. I make a loose call, and a pretty little deuce of clubs hits the turn, giving me a strong flush draw to add to my two overcards. I check again, and he checks back, and another deuce hits the river. Damn it. I check, he checks back, and he shows me pocket sevens, confirming that he in fact does have it every time. I'm just out here giving chips to the guy in first place. Sweet.
Dinner! This is the dinner you invited me to. That was tonight. That's why I'm here.
Sit, please.
Dinner break chip counts. Week 3.
154.
Greg is subbing for Kenny this week, and he's killing it. He has 75,050.
60.
60.
Just under double.
45, 50K.
16 over starting stack.
46,000.
42,000.
41.
We got about 40.
Let's ride.
38,000.
36,000.
35,000.
Over starting.
31,000.
Just under 30K.
More than you.
28,000.
25,600. 25,000.
24,2.
23,600.
22,000.
18,200.
17,300.
About 16,000.
14,700.
12,100.
Less than 10,000.
How many do I have?
I have 8,675.
4,500.
Not much.
I don't know.
Dude, when I count my chips, it gets all fucked up. I don't want to know.
For dinner, we're eating this stuffed pork chop, double chop, broiled stuff with sausage, bacon, spinach, Asiago, Fontina cheese, serve with garlic mashed potatoes, and some pork gravy. Let's get it.
Here's the view. If we're going to rate it out of 10, we'll let you know. It was really good. Dinner break's ending, so I'm not going to be able to finish it right now. We'll give it an 8.67. I'm going to keep having Tony pick my meals every week, and let's see if he can beat the 8.67 next week. Thanks, Tony. Back from dinner, nothing has changed. Jesse pops it up to 3K under the gun, and it folds around to me. I'm running out of options and decide it's time to throw a Hail Mary. I call his raise in the big blind with 3-4 of diamonds, praying this suited connector can score me a double up. The flop comes 5-queen-3-rainbow, and I check it over to the bully. Jesse snap bets 10,000, which is even more chips than I have left. And now it's a decision for my tournament life. I'm beating him here almost always if he made that raise without a queen or a pocket pair. But there's still so many hands that have me beat. If I fold, I leave myself with 4,700 chips, which would be a disaster. And if I call and win, I would still have hope today. So that's what I do. I make a hero call, and I'm happy to see Jesse turn over ace 10.
Wow, what a call. What a call.
Oh, don't do it.
Yes.
Eight of spades. Oh, yeah. Eight of spades on the turn, two hearts on the river. We double.
Ha! Got he! Got he! Oh!
We doubled to 16,900 chips, and for now, I couldn't be happier. Let's go.
With blinds at 600-1200, TJ is in the big blind with queen jack off. Jesse limps under the gun, and it folds to Mark in the small blind, who completes. TJ checks his option, and they go three ways to a flop. The flop comes jack 6-7 with two hearts, and they all check. The turn is a 7 of spades, and Mark leads out 6,000? Mark, what are you doing here? I think you actually might get TJ to fold this. TJ does fold. What a fish. Nice hand, Mark.
A few hands later, it folds to Mark, who limps, and when the action's on me, I rip my last 13,400, disrespecting Mark's limp, and obviously hoping for either three folds or a call and a double up. The blinds get out of the way, and it's up to Mr. Mark.
Or I can just knock that ass out right about now.
Table's more fun with me at the table, Mark. It seems I'm putting him in a pretty tough spot, and I remember praying for a fold. And guess what? I have no clue what I had here, and I didn't even catch it on camera either. It must have been a hand that wasn't that memorable.
Well, he ain't gonna get it on me, man. I'll get you next.
You said
time.
He had ace queen?
He ends up folding. Bad fold, Mark.
Got he!
And just like that, 10 people are out. We select a card that will give us our new seat, and I'm headed to table 2, seat 2, with 17,600 chips.
Got Burrito here, Dave, and then Matt and Josh just moved with me.
A few hands into the 800-1600 with the 1600 big blind ante level, I pick up ace queen on the button. Across the table, Dave L raises to 3600 when it folds to him, and Matt W next to act immediately has that I'm gonna at least call face. He does indeed end up making the call, and it folds to me. Ace queen is a great hand, and I would have position on these two if I do call, but calling would leave me with exactly 10,000 chips, which would only be like 6 big blinds, and these are two of the most solid players in the league, so chances are I'm beat already. I'm on the button, so I would get to see many free hands and have a bunch of opportunities to take a stand with my current chip stack if I do fold. So, I fold, and I wait for a better spot. The blinds fold too, and they go heads up to a flop. It comes 5-7-4 rainbow, and yeah, that's definitely not a flop I wanted to see with ace-queen against these two players. Dave checks, and Matt bets 3,000. Dave does call, and I deal the 3 of clubs on the turn. They both check this time, and the 9 of spades hits the river. On this card, Dave immediately reaches for chips and bets 6,500. Matt thinks it over for a while, but eventually lets it go. Nice bluff, Dave. A level later, I'm in the big blind with ace queen of hearts. Dave P limps under the gun plus 1, and Burrito limps in early position as well, and it folds to me. I shove the rest of my chips in the middle, and while Dave is thinking, I see Burrito cutting out calling chips.
Take 2 steps back and wait your turn.
Dave does fold.
You don't gotta do it, bro. They're gonna get a lot of TV time if I stay here.
And Burrito does make the call. He shows me pocket nines, and suddenly we're in a very similar position as last week. The flop comes 5-6-6 rainbow, and the three of hearts hits the turn to give me flush hope. Two overs and a flush draw to save our tournament life. Do we hit? No, we don't. And I'm out in 26th place.
.42 points is another early out, but at least it wasn't as bad as the 36, but it's pretty much just as bad. Busted a pocket nines 2 weeks in a row with two overs. 0 for 2 in those flips. I don't think I got above starting stack all day. It was a tough tournament for me. But we just suck it up, come back in 2 weeks, and have a really good finish week 4, and then we're right back in it. That's the goal. We still have a chance to win this league, but we're not going to be able to have a similar finish anytime soon. Jesse busted 2, 39 points. Just out here. Crying. Good luck, everyone.
Here's your Vineland Poker League Week 3 final table. For the first time this year, there's no monster chip leader here. In fact, it's pretty even up top. The three names in parentheses are subs, so good job to them for helping out their buddy. And here's some good news for everyone else in the league. No one from the current top three made the final table. In fact, the whole current top 10 didn't make it here, with the exception of both Daves. That could blow this league wide open.
Just to feel my soul.